Hey everybody, welcome back to Let's Play Croc Legends of the Kobos. In the last episode we entered the third level in the fourth world, which is the last world of the game. Don't miss the box, you dumbass. There we go. Okay, so what this level is, it's basically a level full of mini-games. And that's basically all there is to this level, and that probably makes it the shortest level in the entire game. But it's still pretty fun to do, actually. It's a pretty cool level. Except for this area. Stupid pot. Seriously, I hate this thing. And you can't die like you could in the actual pot minigame in World 2. Now don't go too far out of your way. What happens if I do this too long is I start jumping sideways and then I start missing the buttons, so that's how I eventually miss them. At least that's what happened in the last take. It's like take 7 or something of this episode, it's ridiculous. There we go, it's already going sideways. Dude, this is ridiculous, stop it. Don't make me go that far out of my way for one gem. Oh, there we go again. Okay, one up. Yeah. Okay, I'm still jumping straight. That's cool. Oh man. They start falling even faster now. So nerve-wracking. This is the one minigame in the entire game that makes my hands sweat, seriously. Not that you guys want to hear that. Are you done yet? Seriously, cut it out. You get the idea, catching gems with a pot. Can we stop now? Another one up. Yes! Okay, we made it this time. So let's move on, and for some reason that made the emulator lag. Ah, this is easy. Dude, I am not talking. Seriously, what's wrong with me? I guess I'm trying to concentrate, but yeah, I don't really care if I miss one. I think I already hit enough of them to get the reward. Yeah, this is what I mean. See, now I'm jumping sideways, and that's what usually happens when I do the pot mini game. That's how I miss those buttons eventually. And our last gobo will be in this room, or actually not in this room. This is just there's nothing that you have to do in this room, or at least nothing you can get in this room. So you have 3 doors here. There's one problem. This guy can blow up one of the doors, but of course when you let him blow up, you can enter the other door. So what you have to do is you have to find the right one. I'm gonna pick the left one. I think on the right there's only a gong and... Yeah, one of them is a gong. I don't really remember what the other two are. This one goes to the other 4 color gems, to the last gobo and to the bonus area. So that's where you want to go. That's the only required thing you have to do here. And I have 31 freaking lives. That is amazing. I died a couple of episodes ago, and now I have 31 lives. So let's do this. See if I remember this one. Oh yeah, this one. This is maybe this is even easier than the first one that we saw. Oh crap! I went the wrong way. Supposed to go this way first, because this is where you're gonna find the key. No, you won't. I don't want to lose those gems. Not now. Okay. This way now. should be over here. Okay, that is 6. I think what I'm gonna do in this recording session is I'm just gonna finish up the game, since there's only a couple of levels left for me to do. And yeah, after that I'll probably have to decide what my next side LP is gonna be. I have kind of an idea what I wanna do next, but I'm still not sure if I have practiced that enough. So, it is time for another boss level. Pretty easy one, actually. I don't really mind this boss battle so much. Not as much as the one in the third world. Oh my god, that stupid fish. Should be a 1-up on this side, so I'm gonna go over here first. Should be in this one. There we go. Be careful, because those platforms will shrink and then disappear, so make sure you don't stay on top of them for too long. Like that! I was just rushing. That's not a good idea. It's never a good idea. Yeah, I don't think this LP will be longer than Rayman 2 or Spyro. I think it will be even shorter, maybe as long as Rayman 2 was, I don't know. So this is what you have to do. You have to he throws those walking bombs at you, and all you have to do is just lead him over to one of those things. And then you can you should be able to hit him with it. Like that. He has only one hit left. So this is easy. He almost won this battle. Ah, that's the wrong way, man. Supposed to go over there. There we go. And that's the end of our mini-boss. And for some reason he survived falling in that bottomless pit. But oh well. What is that thing anyway? That is disturbing, man. Smash and see. I remember this one. This is not that bad. It might take a long time, but nah. I don't really mind this level. So I think what you have to do to get rid of those guys, which is what you have to do to move on, is just smash those boxes and that's everything. That's all you have to do. It's basically all there's... that's basically all you have to do in this level, just make those guys fall in the pit. Do that in a couple of areas and... there you go. Let's see if I can rush through this. Fast as I can, because it's not a hard level, but sometimes it just takes forever for those guys to fall in the pit so you can get the key. Whoa, don't start doing that again. We've done that enough. I am running out of stuff to say. So it appears that we have made a full circle now, so let's wait until those guys drop in the pit. And it seems to be there's one more up there. So if we can get rid of him, we'll be able to move on. Give me my key. This isn't the last area yet, but I think I'm running out of time here pretty soon. So we're up to 10 minutes. I'm gonna ride this platform up, and as soon as we get up, we're gonna end off the episode, probably. So, thank you guys for watching. And I will see you next time. Let's wait for that guy.